Oh my God. Oh my God. 40 Celsius, 44, 52, 56, 60, 64, 68, 70. You want some?
I did it! He did it!
Hey guys, I'm the Hacksmith, and my team and I take fictional ideas and make real working prototypes. One of our biggest projects yet has been trying to build a system to let me fly like Iron Man. It all started out as a joke when we cracked 100,000 subscribers. I tried strapping model rocket engines to my wrist to see if I could hover. It almost worked too. In fact, if we got bigger model rocket engines, we probably could have hovered, at least for a few seconds. But unfortunately, that wouldn't have been very legal. So we decided to move on to a more sustainable idea, using EDFs, electric ducted fans. They're basically electric jet engines. The issue, however, is the smaller they are, the less efficient they are, which means you can't get very powerful EDFs. That being said, I was able to hover with a counterweight system. Unfortunately, I was just too fat. I'm too fat to fly without counterweights. So we're looking into something a bit more powerful, and that's a jet engine. Now, the tricky part is jet engines are kind of hard to control and not very ideal for vertical takeoff situations like this. So our revised plan is to use EDFs to stabilize my flight and a jet engine, or two, to provide the majority of the thrust. Now, thanks to you guys for supporting our last video sponsor, we were able to order a jet engine. And it should be coming, I think it's here. Let's get this thing open. Is this the edible kind?
Only one way to find out. Oh no! It's not the jet engine. It's just the oil for the jet engine. So you mix this with the jet fuel so that it...
The jet fuel, the diesel.
I thought we were gonna play with the jet engine today.
It makes sense. That box seemed a little small.
All right, back to being bored.
Day two.
We think this is the jet engine now. I don't think we have any more jet oil fuel coming, right?
I don't think so.
Hopefully.
Well, there might be some in here.
Maybe. So if this is what we think it is, it's the King Tech G310J, or is it J310G?
This thing.
Ooh, it's that thing. Oh my God. Oh my God. Someone's gonna get hurt. Purchasing this was a bad business
idea. This is not it.
It's even got that burnished cut.
Yeah. Like,
do they purposely do that, or that's from the heat? It might be just from the heat, actually.
Yeah, that's tiny. It looked bigger in the picture. This looks like the fuel pump. Again, tiny.
Yeah.
I'm surprised this is able to put out enough fuel. These things guzzle diesel. Is this the electric motor?
I
think this might be the electric motor for starting.
Yeah. Hey, comes with its own lithium ion battery? Oh, it's so cute. How do you charge this though? Yay, plugging random things in. We should probably set this up properly before messing around with it. It's time to test the jet engine. So the manual says to stay 15 meters behind?
15 feet.
15 feet, okay. Does this look like 15 feet?
Yeah, roughly. All right. Everybody ready? Start on. So it's gonna go through three stages. First, it's going to start spin it up and ignite the fuels that are already in the chamber. Another ignition, it warmed up the glow plug. Now it's on stage one. So what it's gonna do is it's gonna input a little bit of fuel to get the engine up to 75 degrees Celsius. Chances are it's cold outside, so it might actually fail stage one. Because it has a time limit. It's heating up, it's at...
I see some steam coming out.
40 degrees right now. So it's at 40 degrees, it's trying to get to 76 degrees.
Love the smell of fresh diesel in the morning.
Starter on. So it's gonna start heating up. Ignition, 74 degrees Celsius. There it goes, stage two. Now it's gonna try to get...
I just drank a liter of gas in this test. A whole liter. It's gone now. I don't want to strap that to my body.
I bought that gas can just for you. I was like, that's a cool gas can. Brogdon would like that. So this is 5% turbine oil. Why are you spilling everything? And the rest is diesel. Because this actually runs better with diesel than it does with jet fuel. How awesome is that?
The neighborhood must hate us. Like, how loud is this out on the street?
I don't know.
All right, so the purpose of that test was to actually measure the thrust output from the jet engine to make sure we were hitting the specification from King Tech. And to do that, we were using the thrust test jig that Bogdan designed, which records all the data from both the jet engine and the sensor to tell us how much thrust is actually being produced. And as you can see, the graph looks a lot nicer than our EDF test. The thrust and throttle pretty much stay next to each other. And as you can see, we actually hit a total thrust of 32 kilograms, which is pretty good because the specified thrust on King Tech is 31 kilograms. So it's actually over spec, which is awesome. So now that we know that the jet engine produces enough thrust, let's do a few safety tests. One of the issues with the jet engine is the heat of the exhaust is really high and you can literally burn yourself quite badly. Not to mention, you're supposed to stand 15 feet away from these things and I'm planning on strapping them to my body. Let's see exactly how dangerous these are.
This will give us about 2 minutes of runtime. Probably less because the startup sequence takes like 30 seconds.
This, I haven't seen better days, but we don't really want to wreck a brand new one. So we're going to use this guy
who survived the rebar crossbow video. I mean, the back of his head didn't, but his face is still pretty good. So we'll be able to see the face melting in action.
Is that long enough?
Probably.
I think so.
You got the other
Ivan head?
Yep.
This Ivan head will live to see another day.
Not for long.
Not for long. Can we screw down those pieces of bone? I don't know. Or strap down, maybe? Man, the back of his head's caved in a little bit.
And it smells really bad. Okay.
Celsius, 44, 52, 56, 60, 64, 68, 70, 104, 100, oh wait.
H2, spin up.
His face is gone. It's gone. It's gone.
That only got you 600 degrees. That wasn't max temperature.
All right, so for test two, we're just gonna use a regular styrofoam test. In retrospect, this probably should have been the first test we did, but I think it's like completely gone. What are you thinking? See what happens. Wow. And for our final test, roasting a hot dog. Do not try this at home.
Ready?
Yep. It ripped itself to pieces more than cooking. Oh, look at this though. It's a nicely cooked sausage. You want some?
I did it. He did it.
All right, that was freaking awesome. Though I am getting a bit nervous about strapping jet engines anywhere near my body. Anyways, you guys might be wondering, what exactly is our design? Well, we have this really rough mock-up that we made in SOLIDWORKS showing the basic concept for our initial tests. Now this is basically a platform we're going to build to see if we can actually make a system that works as a hybrid between jet engines and EDFs. Once we have that working is when we can start shrinking it down and hopefully end up flying like Iron Man. Anyway, we should be getting the Schubler EDF very soon, which can put out about 24 kilograms of thrust. And we'll be doing similar tests that we did with the jet engine, and then we're gonna start seeing if we can get them to work together, as well as probably a few more sponsorships to see if we can get more jet engines. Because remember, the goal here is to not need to be a really good pilot. The system should do all the stabilization for you, hopefully resulting in my life continuing and not ending in a fiery ball of fire. For Ian's 3D model animation of the platform, you might need some sound effects, so...